Okay.
Well, I am a college student. I'm a senior at Point University. I skipped class this morning. I really hope my professors are okay with that. I meant to give them a shout out. There are definitely some struggles that you go through, I think, because you can get really, I know for me, I'm a Christian college student. I mean, I go to Christian University, so I take a lot of Bible classes, so it's easy for like Bible classes to become routine versus something you like go dig into your Bible as the thing you want to do. But you just really have to have a great accountability partner, great support system around you, people that you know are just kind of encouraging you to dig in the Word and pray and all that stuff. That's really what it takes there. This song on R&B radio or whatnot, and even though, you know, I listen to some country and some pop, you know, growing up, my parents have always been able to age appropriateness, so they exposed me to gospel music, Christian music, Southern gospel, and Sesame Street. They didn't let me listen to all the other stuff that I had to be singing myself. So I really was in a room in a building of people that I really admire and look up to and whose songs have had a personal impact on my life. Sure, since I was about 8. The way my mom explains that is that I've been acting crazy ever since I was 8. I actually didn't even start acting until about a year ago. But I've always been interested in it. I would love to do movies and television. My mom was a radio announcer in Los Angeles before I was born. I would love to follow in her footsteps and do that kind of thing. He's amazing. I mean, my very first concert as a little girl was DC Talk and Carmen. And so I love DC Talk and Carmen. Getting to work with Toby Mack on an artist level, I mean, he's very talented. He knows his stuff, but at the same time, he gives me space to grow as an artist. But ultimately, he's a strong man of God. And his family comes first and then his ministry. And that's something that that I really look up to him for. I'm a senior in college now, so 4 years ago, when I was senior in high school, my prom was here, the Georgia Home School prom. Yes, we have friends. And so that's really amazing to come back and is this the Egyptian ballroom, is it? Or am I wrong?
Right.
That's what my prom was, the Egyptian ballroom. So it's a mind-blowing experience to get to. I cannot explain it. Hello. I have something called Tourette's syndrome. It's a condition that makes me make tics that I can't control. I do this a lot, and a lot of other annoying and sometimes painful things. It's been very tough over the years. I remember I was 13 years old. I'm so emotional. And I was meeting Zoe Girl, and I was twitching up a storm. I was doing all my twitches. I was really bad. I was physically just overwhelmed and exhausted. And one of the girls looked at me and she said, thanks for coming to the concert. And I said, I'm so sorry, my child. It's so embarrassing. And she looked at me and said, you're beautiful and don't ever change. And I just want to do that same thing for someone else. I mean, it's definitely an honor. I wasn't expecting to win it. I just kind of, my friends, you know, my sister's on a mission trip in Macedonia. I miss her so much, and she was texting me. She was like, you're going to get it. And I was like, let's not get it in our heads, ladies. Like, we're not going to win, but it's going to be fun. So the second they said my name, I broke down. It means so much to me that it's my hometown, that my mom and my daddy are both here. My aunts are here. Even when I sing later, one of my friends from high school was singing with me. So just those moments, like the nomination and all that stuff is great, but I just love being connected to home. That's what's most important to me.